I am Hussein from Nawagaon, Tehsil Sadrabad and District Shekhpura. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent and the most merciful. Honorable guests, dear judges, and my dear fellow, Assalamu alaikum. I stand here today to speak on a topic, Sirat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are the present, we do Allah, the Lord of the world, the master of the day after, and the creator of everything in the world. Peace and salutation we boon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who brought him up from the darkness into brightness and guide us the right way of life. Mr. President, all the praises be to Allah. My Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born in Makkah in 571 AD in the home of Hazrat Abdullah. He belonged to the tribe of Quraysh and brought up by his grandfather and his uncle. My soul was a normal person even before his Nubuwwat and even before his Nubuwwat. In the age of 40, the God sent his first message by revealing the Ayat of Quran and Hadith. After this struggle was started to preach in Islam. Dear judges, it is a great blessing of God that He showed His blessing upon us by giving us birth in Ummah of His Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet who was called the messenger of the Allah, who was entitled as the Rehmat of the Alameen. Dear judges, there was a time when the land of Arabia was a worst place to live in for humanity. Blood is the cheapest thing in society. Women were considered as a public property, where God was buried alive. Then God sent His Rasul, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who took the earth from the depths of the earth to the heights of the sky. Dear fellows, my soul, the personality of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, dominated the mind of Allah to such an extent, because most in a short period of time, most of them embraced Islam. They embraced Islam, become the followers of Islam, follow the teaching of Islam, and we left His way, we forget His sin, and we are the most pitiable person in this society. Now, it is our moral duty to respect the teachings of Islam and the glory of Islam in itself. In the end, I would like to say that a little drops of water, a little drops of water, a little grain of sand makes the mighty oceans and the beauteous land. And the little moment, humble though they may be, make the mighty ages of candy. Thank you, Mr. President, for giving me so patient a hand. Thank you all.